Now back to live in Las Vegas with your hosts Dave Carney and Chad Forster. Yay!
Alright, welcome back to Live in Las Vegas here on News Talk 720 KDWN, streaming worldwide, KDWN.com. Dave, Chad, Ray, Bullish, Brian, Sahara Coins, and Precious Metals. Guys, the culmination of our month-long promotion here on KDON. Thanks again to yourself, to Cheryl, to Alex, and the rest of the crew down here at Sahara Coins for offering us up such great stuff for the holidays, Ray. We've been talking about it. You guys have been registering online at SaharaCoins.com, and here it is. We're going to be drawing the winner for a 2014 quarter-ounce Gold Eagle.
Chad. Well, and that's not it. What else do you have there, Ray?
So in my hand, yes. I hold a Sahara Coins t-shirt, a 2014 quarter-ounce Gold Eagle, and two more tickets to the Jeff Civilico show. And first of all, before we say the name, thank all of you for coming down and being here. We really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
All right. And this is a must-be present to win, correct?
It is a must-be present to win, so if you're not here, you don't get it.
And the winner is Debbie Dickinson. Debbie Dickinson, if she's here, she just won 2014.
Is Debbie
Gold
Dickinson
Eagle.
Here?
Oh, whop, whop,
oh, I believe Debbie's here.
All right, you got to keep it going.
Keep it going, keep it going.
Here we go.
All right, okay, how about Mike Mullen? Is Mike Mullen
Mike
here?
Mullen.
Boom.
Mike Mullen.
Boom, you are the winner.
Because it's shirt, man, boss.
Well, there we go. We've got, boy, we don't get to do this very often, guys, live on air, you know, giving away stuff. Now, Ray, do you guys have any more prizes left to give away in the back there?
I think we're empty.
We are kind of empty now. Well, you guys have really done a great job today giving away the farm here. Thanks again, too, to Joe's New York Pizza. For providing such great victuals for us throughout the afternoon. That is some really, really strong pizza, guys.
Solid. Very, very solid. Thank you to Joe's. Thanks to Sahara Coins. And for everybody that's coming down here and spending the time down here.
Very, very much. It's been a blast to see so many folks, listeners here of KDON, you know, folks that like coins come out here and join us today.
Also, guys, I wanted to say a quick thank you to NPM VSM for coming out videotaping us, because you will see these videos online. They do an amazing job. They do all of our educational videos. I really appreciate it.
And say that one more time.
NPM VSM. You can find them online. Great guys.
We've been having such an easy time saying these saying these things today. I figured I was going to let you tackle that. Now, guys, wrapping up the show here today, we're going to kind of stay on sports because there's a couple of other things I wanted to touch about. You know, and of all the things that we've talked about over the last couple of weeks on the sports carnival, I don't think anything has been more commented on, more discussed, and possibly more ridiculed than the UNLV hire of Bishop Gorman coach Tony Sanchez as their new head coach. Now, early reports out of UNLV are saying some good things about Tony Sanchez, really liking his energy, liking his direction. They think he's a smart guy that could give the team a bright future. Well, now we've started to get a look, fellas, at his staff that he's putting together. The most recent is an interim coach from Nebraska, I believe.
Coach Cotton
was brought on to be the offensive coordinator for the Rebels. Now, Ray, you played semi-pro ball. You played in high school. What do you think about the move to bring Tony Sanchez on? Where do you think it leads the university? And was this the right decision?
You know, I think it's an interesting decision, to be honest with you. You know, I'd heard not too long ago, I actually read it online, there was an article about, you know, the big thing that's been going around is the fajitas and the money coming along with them. And one of the things that I'd read about was they do currently have a child who plays at Bishop Gorman. As far as I had read, he hasn't committed to anybody, anything like that. So, you know, maybe my mind digging a little far, maybe overthinking it, but you now have his coach at UNLV. You know that his parents give to the booster club, quote unquote. And, you know, you now have his old coach at UNLV. What do you think the chances of him showing up at UNLV are along with his awesome family?
Well, I mean, listen, there's something to that. I mean, I think that's obviously part of the underlying and maybe the unsaid message here is that a lot of the reasons Tony Sanchez was hired, at least according to folks out of the Las Vegas Review-Journal, Chris Matthews, Mark Anderson, who we had on the program a couple of weeks back, was because the Fertittas had at least promised to somebody somewhere in the neighborhood of $30 million. Now, whether or not that's true,
well, both sides
don't know.
Are denying that, though. The Fertittas have denied it, and so is UNLV. No check has been promised, but, you know, a lot of commentators have said this, and I agree with them. Without the money, this doesn't make a lot of sense. This isn't the first time a high school football coach has been hired at the next level, and unfortunately for Tony Sanchez, he would be a trailblazer if he makes this work, because the other two guys didn't turn out so well.
Yeah.
So we'll see what happens. I think it's smart, very, very smart, if you're going to have a guy like this that's never been at this level, to bring a guy in like Coach Cotton, who is over, you know, now interim coach at Nebraska. Somebody that has some tenure that understands the ins and outs of not only recruiting, but, you know, just the difference in speed and the way the college game is played at Division I level.
Well, then let me say, I'm not saying that I don't think he has the talent to do this, because I think he is a great coach. Obviously,
clearly,
he's done some great things.
Sure.
But like you said, it's a whole nother level. You get up there, the pace of the game changes. The way that you plan your game completely changes. I mean, there's a lot of things that are going to go. But these other coaches he's bringing in may be the ticket to making success.
The other way to look at this, and I think Dave and I have talked about this before, when you look at Bishop Gorman, that's not a normal high school. Okay, so a normal public high school, you get the players you get with who's ever in the neighborhood. And sometimes you look out, sometimes you don't.
Right.
But Bishop Gorman, they recruit. I mean, you can pay to go there, correct?
Yes, yes. Yeah, absolutely.
So if I look at it like that, I'm looking at Tony Sanchez as kind of the, you know, I guess Nick Saban of high school football, but what does that translate to the next level? So in other words, he has all of these great players to draw from because he's at Bishop Gorman. It makes it a little easier to coach. Now, when he goes to UNLV, he's not going to have probably one blue chipper,
no,
let alone a whole team.
Right. And let's not forget, too, the reason that Tony Sanchez has been successful in recruiting to Bishop Gorman, at least one of the reasons, not to mention the national prestige that Bishop Gorman has garnered. A large part of that is due to the success Tony Sanchez has had. Look at the institution from an educational, look at it from an aesthetic point of view, and you'll see Bishop Gorman for what it is, one of the top academic institutions for high school in the nation. You couple the fact that they've got one of the top athletic programs in the nation, and it makes perfect sense that you send your kid to Bishop Gorman. Now translate that to UNLV for me. UNLV is nowhere near, and I say this with all due respect, is nowhere near the top 100 educational institutions in the country. It is nowhere near the top 25 athletic institutions, especially on a football level. Even if you incorporate our basketball, you know what, I'll put that in the in the bucket. If you put our basketball, baseball, and golf programs in there, then possibly we're a top 25 school nationwide. But football, being as laughable as it has for as long as it has, it's not going to be any sort of magic bean. Okay, Tony Sanchez isn't going to walk from Bishop Gorman's gorgeous Gale Stadium over to Sam Boyd Stadium, where, you know, the nearest Henderson residents don't even want you to play the game because it makes traffic bad that day. You're not going to get them to bring kids out here. Now, the ones that were going to Bishop Gorman, they've got every single right to pursue the best opportunity possible for them. If somebody comes to them and says, I will offer you a scholarship at Notre Dame, or you can go to UNLV, if you're a parent of that child, you would be derelict if you sent your child to UNLV.
Tell me
it to Notre Dame.
Tell me what this says, and this is in the RJ, in the sports section, Mark Anderson, who obviously we had on our show before this decision was made, and he had said that this is the way it was going to go. It looks like that the Regents voted today, and it's unanimous, 11-0. So what does that say to you? That says to me that either we've got some Regents that are out of touch or some Regents that know that they're getting a $30 million check.
Well, if they're not getting the $30 million check, look, we've talked about this angle as well. This is a go-for-broke move for UNLV. They've saved money. It's a bit of a cost-cutting maneuver on their part. They were paying Bobby Houck $700,000 during the last years of his contract. They bought him out with a $400,000 lump sum. Now, Tony Sanchez is going to make $400,000 a year, but only $250,000 a year are going to be counted as salary. The other monies are going to come from media and press appearances. So the way that the Regents approve these things is a little bit different than how we give a vote of confidence to somebody, say, at the professional level when you're hiring them. This is
right.
Something that needs to be passed through a state legislative session. And for $250,000, you're like, the hell, let's give it a try. Who is it?
That's
like,
true.
It's the high school coach, right? Yeah, okay, we'll give him a go.
Yeah, how bad can it be?
Ah, they won six championships at Bishop Gorman. We'll see. Great show, Ray. Thanks again so much for everything today. This has been fantastic.
Yeah, thank you guys. Appreciate it.
No, it's been awesome. All right, coming up tomorrow, Chad and I are going to be jumping into Everything Under the Law live in Las Vegas. Judah Zakalik from Peters & Associates joins us for 2 hours, and we're also going to talk about medical marijuana with a representative from the Nevada Medical Marijuana Association. Have a great night. Jerry Doyle coming up next here on KDOT.
Can you really reach your financial goals
if
you don't have a strategy?
Thank you, Terry.
Great job. We'll see you back in here tomorrow.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay.
Money's working for you.